We're going to get somebody else in here. Bobby wants to know what's going on here. Bobby Johnston. We're out here in front of a private prison that's here in America. It's not even owned by the federal government. It's a private corporation that houses over 1,100 people in this building alone. There is torture going on. There's prison cells that are 3 feet by 3 feet that they put guys in. And we've got firsthand witness of this happening in this jail. They're handcuffing people to benches. They're handcuffing people behind their back for 13 hours at a time. And we're trying to bring awareness. We're out here along a deserted highway in the desert, camped out, trying to spread the word and let everybody know. Unless you're going to this prison, you would not even know this exists probably out here. It's outside of the city limits. And but there's a lot of employees that go in and out, a lot of workers, and the town that's about 7 miles away approximately. The townspeople are supporting us. They did not want this prison to go in the first place, and they was trying to shut it down before it ever got built. But there's a lot of money to be made here for politicians in the county, and that's why they went ahead and overruled the citizens of this county and went ahead and allowed this prison to be built. They say just the taxes alone here, this business is supposed to pay us over $1 million a year to this county. No wonder this county doesn't want to lose that $1 million. But there's a right and there's a wrong. And money's never worth somebody's life. Never.
Not trying to interrupt, but we have another political prisoner about to go in.
Let me turn the camera around. We got another volunteer. Turn it around here. So here we go.
Here we go.
We got another volunteer.
AKA. Remember to throw funds in.
Robert's from
every hour is
a little snug. Robert's from Oregon.
Somebody grab the key.
It's owned by a corporation. This is CCA Correctional Facility. It's a holding facility that the federal government pays like a hotel to house.
I was just kidding.
To house detainees that are waiting on trial. There's over 1,100 detainees in here.
So you're going to be doing the next...
Wow, that is awesome.
I'm going to do my best.
Man, we got some awesome people out there.
I'm not very young anymore.
I hear them whistling.
I'm somewhat overweight. I'm already uncomfortable.
You hear them? The boys are yelling at us.
I can't even imagine.
So we got Robert from Oregon. This is Treason Robin.
Got big wrists.
Yep.
Yeah.
Go ahead.
Yeah.
Gonna have to force
them. Yeah, I hear him. Where's the bull?
This automatically, I want to just fight them.
The prisoners are yelling at
us. This one here, my left one, I've got to be able to turn it.
Yeah, they're hooting and hollering at us.
I need to turn it.
Who got the keys back
there?
Take them.
Okay, yeah.
See what you did. You put this hand this way and this hand this way. So you usually take the thumbs and hold the thumbs
right over there.
Throw them on.
I don't ever want to know that.
There you go.
Robin, can you do this?
There you go. My bad. Oh,
hey, I was on some major joint manipulation. Okay.
Oh,
is that a little better?
Okay. I think that first click.
No, I'm just gonna wait for him.
Okay, we gotta open them bars up for him, and we're gonna put.
I'm being dramatic, I know, but this
but
is
But, you
not
know, are
right.
you the, about the size of Ammon?
He's pretty close to about the size of Ammon.
Okay, now this shows you that when you're bigger in the shoulders and stuff like that, and you've got bigger hands and arms, it puts a lot of pressure.
That left one's way
Attention!
I'll let it out.
It puts
we're out here for you!
And
so let me hear ya!
We're going to have to loosen that one. But yeah, I'm sure Ammon wasn't given that.
I mean, I'm much taller than Ammon, but he's a big shoulder.
Oh, they're going to start hooting and hollering here in a bit.
Yeah. I wanted to say that because of his shoulder size and
arms
and everything else.
Huh?
What's happened?
You didn't do it.
I did. I let it out almost all the way.
All right.
Ain't giving up. We're closing this place down.
All right.
We got Robert here from Oregon. He's, and his dog's wondering what's going on. This is his dog. And I don't know if we should put his dog in there with him or not, but that'd be torture.
Yeah,
we won't do that.
Eat it out here, and if the animal rights people come out and they find a dog incarcerated.
They would probably lock us up for treating that dog that way. But you're okay.
You guys, if I never get out of here and I'm detained indefinitely, Well, I've already talked to somebody here about, I just really care about, and he cares about me, so to be in here and be separated from one's animal, which makes me think of Joe Robertson, how close he was to his dog, it breaks my heart to think that someone's unrightly, unjustly locked up and they're separated from human or animal that loves them so much. It's wrenching, absolutely heart-wrenching. I don't know.
Yeah.
When I heard about this, of Ammon, and I forget who it was that had the phone call with him.
Hey, Rob, Cody is not going in with him. If I'm going to show, Rob, I'm going to show you that these are actually PVC, so he can come out at any time. So the dog wants to go in. He's like, hey, Dad, what are you doing, you little dork?
We've already got a... a few people that donated, Robert.
Thank you.
Got one gentleman, $10 an hour already.
Wow.
And another lady that's donated already a while ago that she's donating more money too. Thanks, Judy.
Thank you.
So we've got, yes, it's 6:40 p.m. Nevada time, James. Thanks.
Yeah, already I'm just trying to manipulate and to get a little bit more comfortable on my wrists. I mean, the first thing you... think about it.
Lindsay Burrell's $10.
It's nothing about the body yet. It's about my wrist.
Yeah.
A guy by the name of Moore, he's asking what's going on here. Again, I'll explain. I know there's a lot of new people hopping on and trying to figure out what's going on down here. We're in front of a prison that's the Nevada Southern Detention Center. And this road had been blocked off. This prison had been on lockdown. They had, I see Garrett's asking the same question. So this prison back here, it's about a half a mile back, was under lockdown. They had abused and mistreated a prisoner and beat a prisoner and locked a prisoner up in a cell that's this size right here, 3 foot by 3 foot. Sarah Redbuck's giving $5 an hour towards you too. So
Sarah Redbuck, you are a special woman. Thank you.
So we've got
he's got a very
we've got a jail cell we built here that's similar to the same size as what they have in this prison. This other gentleman was locked in here for 13 hours with handcuffs behind his back, and he also had ankle shackles on. And he was left that away for 13 hours in a concrete box. And you can see Robert's dog here would like to be in there with him, and doesn't like it that he's
happy outside. He doesn't want to come in. He just wants to
make sure you're okay.
He's not really witnessed me being in a situation like this.
Yes.
So he has some concern, but he likes y'all.
Yes.
Yeah, he's wondering what's going on.
Yeah. So we also, Mr. Moore, we also had another guy that was in this same prison that was handcuffed that we know about for 4 days to a bench. And no bathrooms, left to urinate on themselves, and it's just horrible conditions. Things that I don't even like to talk about on live stream. Pretty horrible. And these guys have not even been convicted of anything. We're treating people inhumane that have not even been convicted of a crime yet. They might have been charged with a crime. They can be found not guilty by jurors. And some of these guys have already been found guilty, found not guilty by jurors in a previous trial. They 16 months some of these guys have been in here that we know. There's over 19 of them. 16 months in prison without bail. And it could be any of you guys. People on this live stream that are making fun of people that don't do a crime and say things like that, your day will come. They can get you for a DWI. They can get you for all kinds of things and lock you up without bond if this thing continues. You deserve bond as a human being. You do not deserve to be tortured. No human in this country, in this time and day, deserves to ever be treated inhumanely. I see people again asking how they can donate. If you donate right now, we're putting this in Robert's name, but it's for the legal offense here, a defense that's helping some of these guys that are incarcerated, and that's www.bundydefense.com, and it goes directly to the legal defense, and that is helping in this case here that we're trying to help these guys. We help these guys out, we help other guys out. We change bad laws, we can change a lot of things in this country, and that's what needs to be done. This needs to be spread out to the world that this type of abuse is happening. And Matt Smith says they'll lock you up for anything, and they will. Once you're the one locked up, says an average American, we just looked it up on Google, commits 3 felonies a day. So pretty much what that means is you're an unconvicted, you just haven't been caught for your felonies. So does that mean you should give up all your rights just because you haven't been caught? People that these unjust laws.
And I need to keep those safe, so they need to go in the motorhome.
We'll put it in an evidence bag for you.
So we got these nice eyeglasses we can auction.
hope the evidence doesn't get lost.
Put them on the table in there and grab yourself a beer, because I'm not going to be needing one beer for at least an hour.
So he's doing the challenge right now, and he just started it, and his shoulders and wrists are already hurting.
It's extremely uncomfortable on the wrists. In fact, I've tried... I've inadvertently clicked them both tighter, trying to mess with them.
Oh, he didn't lock them.
Oh, because okay. They moved on me.
Okay. BJ's fired as a cop.
Well, good. He doesn't want to be that, because BJ does not have the heart to abuse people. He's a good man. I know he's a good man. I've
right,
been friends
right.
with him.
I'll fix your cuffs here in just a minute. I'll fix your cuffs.
But boy, you get an itch on your nose or something, and that alone is like a temporary torment. No, I have less than 5 minutes.
Yeah.
Jared stayed in here for how long?
4 hours.
Mr. Moore asked how long does it go on. We don't know, Mr. Moore. We're out here for as long as it takes. It could be a couple of days. It could be a couple of weeks. We just think this needs to be brought awareness to this. The locals in this town have been supporting us and coming out here. There's a lot of people that have not been able to stand up on their own, and they appreciate people coming in and helping them bring awareness to this type of situation. We've got the last guy that was just in here, as some of you might, says, tell him I love him so much for doing this. This is what someone here says on Facebook, Robert.
Jeremy Boss says, love you guys.
So, hi, Dwayne Emmer.
Well, you know what? I love anybody that is paying attention and watching and is asking questions and being involved, because a lot of people can't come here physically, but they pay attention on all the live streams, and they're involved, and they're doing their part to try to turn this thing around in our country, and I thank them. I love them.
Well, what you're doing, it takes a lot too, because I personally won't get in there, because I know how bad it hurts. I know how bad it hurts, and I'm not going to subject myself to that, but that's why I'm live streaming, because I want you guys to know what's going on and what's happening out here. And he's approximately the same size as Ammon Bundy, and I really want to emphasize the size of his shoulders really puts more pressure on each one of his wrists. And so because his shoulders are so wide, what it does is that's an unnatural position to be in, with the hands behind the back like that. And that's why we do it as officers, because it puts them on the defense. It puts them, they can be less aggressive unless they really know how to kickbox or butt with their head or anything else like that. So this helps the officer if it's a bad guy. But with Ammon, with the size, that's why it's so important to, in the state of California, if you're in handcuffs for a certain amount of time, we are legally obligated to uncuff one handcuff like every couple hours and allow the circulation. Allow them 15 minutes to stretch their shoulder, circulate their wrist and everything else. We are mandated by law to do that. And so for them to not do that, they can lose fingertips because they're losing the circulation to their fingers. And that's why Ammon, after 13 hours, could not put his hands up over his head because the blood circulation had been gone in his shoulders. And like the young man said earlier, it was like working out for 3 solid days. His shoulders were hurting. So after a couple, I don't know how long he's going to stay in here, but after that amount of time, we're going to see how his shoulders react to this. Now, I already know, but this is for the viewers and everything else. Go ahead, John.
We've got someone asked again, where is this at? This is in Pahrump, Nevada. So it's just outside of Las Vegas. It's about 80 miles south of Las Vegas. And we're at a
Nevada Southern Detention Center. Yes. It's a private prison.
Private prison. It's owned by a corporation called CCA. You can kind of Google that up on the web there and check it out. But they've been investigated all over the country for these type of actions. They're making millions of dollars off of people. This prison here, another thing that I haven't mentioned yet, they're paying these guys in here to work 20 cents an hour. So just think about this. You haven't been convicted of a crime. You're being held till trial. You can be held for 2 or 3 years because the justice system is so backed up, they don't have time to just get you in a timely manner to put up a trial. So
don't think that the judge that you're going to go to have your trial is going to be equitable, fair, and upholding the Constitution at all. So even after all this time these people have been in here and abused, by the time they do go to trial, then they have to fight some sort of judicial system that's not what we believe America to be.
You witnessed some of them court cases right here out of Las Vegas, Nevada, didn't you?
That's right. I was in court 2 times in Nevada, and the second time I had to stand up. But before I did leave the courtroom, I'll now be known as the man who cried treason. So the judge is just about as bad as I can't imagine if it could get worse.
And your dog is not leaving your side. He's just confused. But he's right here, and he keeps coming to you and looking. And
he's got water out here.
Yeah, but you're his dad, and he's no, he's got food and water and plenty of people to scratch his butt and all that good stuff. But look, he's right there. He's right beside you, and he just plopped down, and he's staying right there. It's a good, loyal dog right there. He's got your back. He's got your back. So we're doing the torture chamber challenge, and this is all the money raised is going to bundydefense.com. And so if you want to donate by the hour or just donate, if every single one of my followers, Facebook friends, blah blah, could donate $1 to this defense fund, you know, I could raise almost $1,000. John Lamb here has how many Facebook friends?
I think there's somewhere right around close to 5,000 plus another 10,000 followers.
There you go. If every single person donated $1.
And the reason $1. We need that legal defense fund funded.
Thank you.
Is because we, the professionals that are on board to go into that courtroom defending Ammon and some of the others is going to have great impact on the outcome. Necessary impact. Because as good of people as the public defenders were for the first trial, we need professionals.
We need the O.J. Simpson team.
Yeah, because they know the issues. They are versed in the issues. They believe that these men are innocent and will give their all for winning this case. And going up against that prosecution team and that judge,
it's not cheap. It's not cheap. And I want to put that out there that it's not cheap. And these lawyers, they charge more because they're worth more. And they're worth more because they do more. And so they've actually hired somebody that's really good. And so each person, $1, just $1. John Lamb's followers, $1. Come on, guys. I'm sorry. Go ahead with what you were saying.
I made my point.
Okay. I'm sorry. I didn't want to cut you off.
That's all right.
And you see his little pooch there. He's not leaving his side.
He keeps getting up and making sure Robert's okay.
Yeah, he's checking on him.
He doesn't go very far away.
Nope, he's checking on him.
Robert made a good point earlier when Joe Robertson went to prison over water. Over just having a pond on his property. Joe Robertson had a service dog. He's a Navy vet. He spent time serving in the military, serving this country, and he bought a piece of property in Montana that he really, really liked, and he was living on, and he put a pond on there. And the federal government ended up prosecuting him for digging that pond without the proper permits. And
polluting the waters of the U.S.
Polluting the waters of the United States, and all he did was dig a pond, and he had his own water. It was his own water. It was no one else's water. It was water that rained come in there and out of the creeks. He's spinning right now. Joe Robertson, they shipped him out of Montana, and they're holding him in Inglewood, Colorado, 18 months in federal prison. These are the kind of laws they make terrorism out of you, because you Joe Robertson now will never be allowed to own a gun. He'll never allowed to vote again. He's never allowed to own a credit card. He's never allowed to even own a video camera or any type of camera at all. These are the restrictions that the federal judge put on Joe Robertson. He had a service dog. They took that dog away from him and took every right. They said they stripped every right, American right, away from him and sent him off to Inglewood, Colorado, all the way from Montana. His own wife cannot even go see him. This is the kind of injustice we're hollering about. We're trying to let the world know. This shouldn't happen. Steven said he just donated $50.
Oh, awesome.
So,
thank you, Steven.
We've got these guys here don't even touch the injustice that's going on across this country. We're here in Pahrump, Nevada. It's a private prison that the federal government allowed a private corporation to build, and they...
For-profit prison.
And they've got over 1,100 people in here waiting on trial. One guy we know is 93 years old. He was a doctor, and they're holding him here. There's many other guys, and they're torturing these guys by locking them up in small cells. The guards are strip searching these guys multiple times a day. And I know some of this stuff is considered legal and stuff for protection, but they're doing this over and over again. And some of these guys consider it rape and don't like being stripped down and locked in small jail cells, the same size as we got here. This jail cell here is a 3 foot by 3 foot. One of the guys that was locked in this cell the other day was left in this cell for 13 hours with leg irons on. He was locked in that cell with handcuffs behind his back for 13 hours without any food or water. Without any food or water. For 13 hours. They took him off of his bed at 10 o'clock at night. At 10 o'clock at night and kept him in there all night long.
I just came over here to get the handcuffs, and he just jumped up and got between me and his dad. So I wanted,
Dale Sills says that he's matching Steven's $50.
I'm going to loosen up your handcuffs, and I'm going to do my best to fix these. BJ is fired as the cop. He's fired.
There.
So I have it.
Is he done?
I have it in one.
I'm fired
click.
As a cop?
You're fired as the cop, BJ.
Are you done already?
No, he's not done. We're fixing.
You didn't lock him, so trying to find comfort, I cinched him up.
So
what I'm doing is, because BJ's fired as the cop, what he did when he put the handcuffs on, he didn't lock them. And so when he was trying to get comfortable, hold on, when he was trying to get comfortable, he actually made them tighter. And by making them tighter, he's now cut off the blood circulation to his hands and everything else a little bit more. So what I've done is I've taken them, unloosened them.
Are you done?
Yes. I've loosened them up.
Oh, yeah. Thank you so much.
And then I locked them.
So after just 40 short minutes, that's all it's been so far is 40 short minutes, we've loosened the cuffs to make it a little bit more comfortable on Robert.
I got poor circulation in those fingers anyway.
Yes.
My whole life, so I don't want to lose a digit here trying to, but, you know.
I don't even know if it was 40 minutes. I think it was 20 minutes. I actually told you wrong, I think.
Yeah.
640, I think, is when the count was.
640.
So, right. What, I got to start over now?
Hello?
No. You don't know? No. But I want to explain that's what happens sometimes when officers put handcuffs on and they don't double lock them, that when he messes with the handcuffs or moves around or leans against the wall, the handcuff will get tighter and tighter and tighter because it's clicking, clicking, clicking. And so what I did was I just released them totally, put it on the first click, and then locked it. I doubt that makes any sense to you guys, but it makes total
sense
to me.
Sure makes sense to me, because they haven't moved.
Okay. So, and he's a lot more comfortable now, too.
Well.
But he also cannot slip his hands out of the handcuffs.
Not these hands.
No, because he has big hands. Somebody with little small hands like mine, what I can do is I can make them smaller, and then they're the size of my wrist, and I can slide out of handcuffs. My wrists are so small, but I know that even putting it on the last thing that he's more comfortable, but he also cannot escape from the handcuffs, if that makes any sense. He's a little bit more comfortable, and he can last a little bit longer, and maybe we can raise just a little bit more money. And the money is going to the www.bundydefense.com. And how does that feel?
Better.
A little better?
Yeah, I'm able to rotate my wrist in there and find a spot where there's no binding, you know. But then it's loose and it slips down, so you got to kind of move it back. And so now I'm not all focused on my wrist right now. Now I'm like noticing the itch on my face and all these other things. And then they say it's only 20 minutes, and Jared went 3 hours.
He went 4 hours.
Oh.
He went 4 hours. So he's been in there 20 minutes and he's like, oh my God. So this gives you guys a perspective.
Time to meditate though while we were all gone. You guys are like full on lights beaming in my face saying, what do you know? Well, I know a few
waterboarding
things.
Him and interrogating him, yes.
I know that.
Well, we can leave the camera on you and just walk away here in a moment and just let it go for a while.
Well, I know that hoping for a fair trial, I mean, I pray these guys,
thanks for everything.
I pray that
see you again.
You gonna spend the night?
Yeah, I'm spending the night, then I gotta run to my kitchen.
Lawyers that are on board for
Ammon
Bundy are gonna make mincemeat out of that judge. That judge needs to be put in here and in there. With her and her cronies. I've never witnessed such. I wish I could say it. I know, because I believe you guys and others of the corruption. But until you're actually able to go there to the courtroom and go inside and go through the DHS security and sit there and listen to this, it's so obvious. Anybody sitting there, and they tell you you can't make a facial expression and show emotion. You have to sit there and be neutral, right? Ha!
And I want to say also that next time you see somebody in handcuffs and they're fidgeting like this, it's not because they're angry or agitated. They're uncomfortable. They're physically uncomfortable, and this is not a natural position to be in. So there might just a tad bit more compassion. you know, I don't know.
They call these correctional facilities. I'm a little bit of a free thinker, and I can't imagine if I spent any time at all in here that I wouldn't come out more angry than I went in there. And what do they call that? Would I have to say at that point that my government radicalized me? I probably would think that.
Well, I can tell you after 20 years, I don't think I corrected anything.
Yeah. So, I don't think Jared went down on his knees until like the second, third hour, but I'm already 30 minutes into it, and I want some sort of...
relief.
Yeah.
You want some sort of relief from the pressure.
You want to be on the list?
So when he gets down on his knees now, he's also maybe twice the age of.
Yeah, I'm not 60 yet, but I'm not all that. Actually, I'll be 57 couple months. So.
Right.
Putting an old person, a Joe Robertson, it's what, 77?
Yes.
Said there's a 90 some in there.
93 year old.
We as America have sinned.
Yes.
To allow this to happen and go on without noticing. I know we're not the first ones to probably stop on the road and cry the injustice, but we love these guys so much and believe in their innocence. What do we have to do, people? How big a statement do we have to make to be peaceful and just go up to the line and not cross it? How far do we have to go to call out this sin that we've got going here in this country to think that this is justified somehow? When are we going to stop it? How many people, why do we have all these? No, I won't go there. I'll stop that.
Well, I don't have a lot of people watching mine. So I'm going to sign off for now, and anybody that wants to watch can go on to John Lamb's, and when he's ready to come out, or in a little while, we're going to come back and check on him, and I'm going to go get myself something to drink, and he's going to be in there for I don't know how long, but we will keep you updated throughout the night. This is Rocky Hall out.
So we haven't even had Robert in there a half hour yet. We had Jared in there for 4 solid hours. And Robert's already feeling uncomfortable, for sure. I'll swing the camera around just a moment, just to take it off of Robert just for a minute, and his dog that is faithfully laying right there by him and isn't going anywhere. And I'll show you around just a minute what we have out here. So this is the torture chamber is what we're calling it. And in this prison, right back down this road, just about a half a mile over. And I don't know if you can see that building back there or not. It's quite a ways past, but back in between the trees, there's a building. And it's called the Nevada Southern Detention Center. And it's ran by CCA. It's a corporation. And they've been mistreating prisoners there, handcuffing them to a bench for up to 4 days without bathrooms, their own urine and feces left to set in it, and even locking people up in solitary confinement in a jail cell that is 3 foot by 3 foot. Handcuffed behind their back with shackles on their legs. And this last gentleman that was handcuffed in there and left that away for 13 hours, his legs were bleeding, his arms were bleeding, he was no water and no food for those 13 hours. And six of the guards here hauled him in there, threw him in there, ripped off his clothes and left him naked. And there's not even no bathroom in there. There's just a hole that was in the floor. If you could think about just some of these little details for a moment. Think about being handcuffed with your hands behind your back with leg irons on or chained up for 13 hours and trying to use the restroom alone, trying to sleep in a 3x3 box like we have over here across the street. it's just uncalled for. These kind of things should not happen to humans. Looks like Robert's dog wants in there with him. He doesn't like it that Robert's in there. So
$50 for the dog. $50 for the dog.
So he's got a good dog there, a faithful dog that would actually go to jail with him. This is our tent out here and stuff we have camped out here in the desert, and our kitchen. There's our campers back there that different people have brought in to stay from across the country. We got another vehicle back there and another camper, a few tents back and behind here. We had actually some outhouses donated to us and that they have brought out this morning. And we have all these chairs out here have signs on them letting everybody know what we're doing here. We're no more prison abuse, in prison abuse, trying to bring awareness here. Here's some of the cars and another motor home up there. We've got more tents and campers behind us back there. But we're camped out here trying to bring awareness to what's going on near this town of Prompt, Nevada. So you can see from a distance here, Robert's still in there. And he hasn't been even there in there an hour.
You are a hard act to follow. In fact, if anybody surpasses you,
it's going to be hard to beat Jared. 4 hours is a long time to be in the heat. And with them handcuffs behind your back like that. We've had nothing but support from the locals here in Pahrump, Nevada. They have donated food, water, cases and cases of water, even brought out hot meals to us last night. Says Rob here says he's got $40 to spring Cody. Thanks, Rob. So, trying to give you a little bit of view out here what we've got again, and some of our signs here. Here we got the van at the far end. We've had pretty much vehicles in and out of here all day long, and this whole parking area has been full most of the time. It's kind of emptied out here towards the evening, but there's going to be probably close to 20 of us out here to stay the night again. We've been staying here 24 hours around the clock. We haven't left here. Camping out, eating here, sleeping here, and bring awareness. These guys in this prison right over here, they never go home. They're there 24 hours a day. Some of them guys have been in there for years without a trial. Some of the guys that we know personally have been in there for 16 months and still haven't faced trial. And solitary confinement to prison abuse to locked up in small solitary cells like this one we have over here. And if you can just imagine, that's what we're trying to bring awareness to it. People can talk about it all day long, but experiencing this is unimaginable. Be put in there for 13 hours, and this jail claims that they can keep you in a cell like this for 72 hours, shackled by your feet and your hands behind your back for 72 hours. And they kept this man in there for 13 hours. Seeing if I can catch up with some of the questions and answers that people have been asking on here. I haven't been reading them for the last few minutes, but and for people that are just jumping on here, this is Robert. He's from Oregon. He came out here to stand with us and show support for these guys that are in prison. And he is doing the torture chamber challenge, the 3-foot by 3-foot cell that they have in this jail right behind us in Pahrump, Nevada. And we're trying to bring awareness to what's going on here and also get some of these guys some attorneys and attorney fees to help support their attorneys while they're here in Las Vegas fighting this trial that's coming up in a few months. The media has been out here. We've had the media out here several times. The day we had one camera crew that came out and took a few pictures and asked a few questions. But we had media when we first started. I expect more to come. They haven't, the media, the actual main media has not seen this torture chamber that we have right now. So if we can get them out here, it'd be great. Let the world know what's going on. This prison was on lockdown. It is not on lockdown right now. We're glad they took the lockdown off, but we want to bring awareness that the torture can't continue.
And it's not just for our guys. It's in general. It's for everybody across the country.
That's right.
Can't continue.
We've been getting volunteers. I haven't been in the box myself yet. I am going to do this challenge, this torture chamber challenge myself. I don't know if it'll be tomorrow or the next day, but we have several volunteers that have already been out here. Our first volunteer spent 4 hours in this box, handcuffed behind his back, and Robert's been in there now probably a little over a half hour.
Telling me the time?
The time's worse knowing or not.
Yeah. Have you ever watched your water boil? Have you ever watched the frog get too hot?
You ever watch paint dry?
Have you ever wondered if that one cloud will drip rain? Have you ever watched the grass grow? It's kind of like that.
Exactly. The worst part, I think, is watching a microwave for 3 minutes and waiting for that food to get warm.
I forgot to tell him in the case to get the tuner.
I got a tuner on my phone.
Well, there you go.
Fine. Sounds good.
We got a guitar.
Hey, Joshua, the plug in on the back side of it, the peg on the back side of the strap.
Yeah.
It's not totally secure, like it'll come out. So.
Okay, I'll be careful.
Yeah.
Oh, that's a 12 string. Woo!
Only 6 strings on it, though.
Oh, I see, it came off.
Anybody seen a pack of.
It's getting cooler out here this evening. We had Josh in there during some of the hottest part of the day, but the sun is still shining bright here.
We got about maybe 30 minutes left of sunlight.
You're still sore, but it's good to go now. I'm out of there.
Listen, Bob Marley.
You just let him play what he's gonna play. Please. It's my only request. It's my dying day.
Hi, Tom.
Cell. I just want to hear Joshua play my
last
guitar.
My last dying request. We got the dog cake taken care of.
Your life feed going still?
Yes.
Ashton, Smith, we're trying to bring some awareness to a prison that we're at out here in Pahrump, Nevada. And we're just trying to show the world what's going on out here in this prison, this holding facility that the federal government has. It's they've been torturing people here. They've been chaining people to benches for up to 4 days. They've been putting people in a jail cell, the same size as this cell that we just built here, 3 feet by 3 feet, handcuffed behind your back, shackles on your feet, and locked up there. The last guy that was just in there spent 13 hours like that without any food, water, couldn't go to the restroom or anything.
I like your guitar, Bob. Feels good on my fingers.
Sounds good, too.
It does.
Can I borrow your lighter, babe?
Strings are getting a little tired, but...
Feels good, though. I'm used to playing mine, and...
It'd be great to have you, Sean, if you could get here. And I know it's hard to get here, but any support, just moral support, kind words, everything's great.
That's why I had a friend years ago that had a Bundy Strat.
I got a nice sunset right behind you.
Well, I don't want to disturb John Lamb's live.
You're okay to sing.
Yeah, we might even get John to sing and play.
Yes, my friend, then set me free again. The bars could not hold me, force could not control me now.
Hello.
They tried to keep me down, yeah.
Wave.
But God turned me around. Yes, I've been accused many of times and wrongly abused now. Yes, my friend, my good friend, them set me free again. The bars could not hold me. Force could not control me now. Feel them spirits. Feel them spirits. Good Lord, hear me. Good Lord, hear me. I'm gonna put it on. I'm gonna put it on.
Thanks, Josh.
Yes.
Made our political prisoner of the day happy.
All for.
Yeah.
Standing up for what's right.
Well, my daughter tore my t-shirts away, so.
More like that?
Got a nice sunset going on.
Well, it's getting dark out here in the desert. Starting to cool down. Got pretty warm today. The locals all went home. Well, we got one local here yet, but he's like family.
Man, it feels a lot better.
There's our family that's local. We don't even realize he lived here. He's with us so much. Thanks, David.
Yeah, huge shout out to David. David does a lot.
David
does, man.
David does, well, a ton. We can't live without him.
See
how David does.
A couple days,
I after I seen what you went through, I'm doubting that. I really am. Because you're all thin and limber and everything. And
what you trying to say? No.
If you got the same bone structure that I do, I'm thin and...
It hurts.
You going to sing us another one, Josh?
Yeah, so,
another prison song of some sort, or do you know any more like that? That was a good one.
That was a good one.
Joshua
and I are.
Come over here and maybe sing right here in front.
Make up songs that come from the heart.
Let me get you a chair ready.
Circulation.
That guitar's already been raked on chair arms and belt buckles by people.
Because what I'm wondering is if you did
I can tell a man that sings
for
his heart.
As limber as you are, because you're not really
know. Prison,
that's
man.
Not a good chair. It's got too much arm.
For 72 hours.
That little red one over there, that little red one is a great little guitar chair. Maybe. I don't know. I want to hear one of your Spanish players.
I'll tell you what.
Yeah, I love what you started doing.
They have to for 72 hours.
Whatever you were playing, I don't hear that.
You know, there's not too many people that can do a torture like that.
Even
a
yeah.
So I want to go request. You requested something that I started playing.
Okay.
It's not a prison song, but
if anything,
it is about the desert.
The money
in Spanish.
That you made, it gives you a little bit of reality of what happens in these places.
Mujeres no me falta ni el dinero ni el amor. Nieteando en mi caballo por la sierra yo me voy. Las estrellas y la luna ellas me dicen dónde voy. Ay, 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 mi amor. Ay, mi morena de mi corazón.
gusta tocar guitarra, me gusta cantar el son. Mariachi me acompaña cuando canto mi canción. Me gusta tomar mis copas, aguardiente es lo mejor. También el tequila blanco con su sal le da sabor. Ay, 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 mi amor. Ay, mi morena de mi corazón. Me gusta tocar guitarra, me gusta cantar el son. Mariachi me acompaña cuando canto mi canción. Me gusta tomar mis copas, aguardiente es lo mejor. También el tequila blanco con su sal le da sabor. Ay, 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 mi amor. Ay, mi morena de mi corazón.
That was Josh Martinez singing, and we've got Robert from Oregon in the jail cell right now.
Get the captain up here for some cell time.
Desiree is requesting that you play that Bob Marley song you played a while back.
Oh.
The one you dedicated to LaRoy, I think.
Oh. You're going to have so much fun, DJ. I'm thinking I'm going to have to ask one of you guys, you know where my phone is up on the dash, and maybe get a picture of me on my phone, eh?
Okay. Yeah, or we can just take a picture with somebody's phone and we can
I took
it
one
to
and no, post it on Facebook.
No, I'd rather have it on my phone. Cause...
You don't like giving your number out?
Revolution? Is that something about right?
Where's your phone at? I'll go get it.
Revolution. Someone else says it's, revolution on here too.
If I were driving the beast, it would be where I
gotta get the cords for that one again.
Now you can't sleep inside this jail cell at all.
Oh yeah. Good night.
Robert's
you
trying to sleep against the wall.
What?
Revelation. Reveals the truth, the revolution. Oh, yeah. It takes a revolution to make a solution. There's too much frustration. Too much confusion. Hey, I don't want to live in the park. Can't trust no shadows at the dark. So my friend, I wish that you could see, like a bird in the tree. The prisoners, they must be free.
Yeah. Yeah.
Never let a politician grant you a favor.
Don't drop it.
They will always want to control you forever. We've got lightning, thunder, and the brimstone, and fire. 'Cause we've got lightning, thunder, and the brimstone, and fire. Let righteousness cover the earth like the water covers the sea. 'Cause we've got lightning, thunder, and the brimstone, and fire. Kill, crump, and paralyze. Oh, we've conception, wipe them out at creation. Creation, creation. Oh, ja, ja. Cause we've got lightning, thunder, and the brimstone, and fire. Cause we've got lightning, thunder, and the brimstone, and fire. Oh, oh.
Revolution.
Bravo. I don't know that I've ever heard that.
Bob Marley. Oh, get up and stretch.
How you feeling, man?
Huh?
How you feeling?
Better now.
I'm good. Yeah. I think that,
yeah, me too.
I think I just lifted my spirits.
If Ammon or any of them guys in there had music like that, it probably would have been too. They was in a cell.
Anything.
Without any light, or with a light on 24 yeah. hours a day. No one to talk to.
There's nothing in a correctional facility that means correction.
No.
What people need is someone that cares and understands. They don't need punishment to correct. What dog ever got better after you kicked him?
No. 16 months in prison here, multiple times in solitary confinement. Some of these guys have been in there 2, 3, 4 years in this prison here. Not our political prisoners, but other guys that we're hearing about. 2 or 3 years inside of this prison without even a trial yet, waiting on trial. Some of them over 3 years. There's a 93-year-old guy sitting in prison here right now that's awaiting on trial that they arrested. And he doesn't qualify for pretrial release. And he's done no violent crime. The crime that they've charged him with, he should be out. He's a retired doctor, and he's charged with writing prescriptions illegally. So he signed some paper for the pharmaceutical companies allowing people to get prescription drugs is what they're saying.
That's
what they're accused of.
That's why we need to go to trial so we can present our evidence, all evidence.
Exactly right.
For our defense, they can't supposedly not let you present evidence that would prove your innocence.
Nope.
But they do. What has happened to us, America?
The reason they don't want to let people out, they can hold 1,100 people here and they can make money. $480 a day for this facility per prisoner. I don't even have a calculator here to do the math, but they're saying that these prisoners they're making $480 a day per prisoner, and then they're paying some of these prisoners that are on good behavior in here that haven't even went to trial yet, 20 cents an hour. 20 cents an hour.
That's
$528,000
a day.
Over $500,000 a day. $500,000 a day.
Just for this one? Or this one?
They're making just for this prison alone. $500,000 a day.
Who makes $480 a day in wages?
No. Wow.
I don't.
No. That's per person in here. It's
so for those who are just logging on, give us an update what we're doing right here.
We are trying to demonstrate what a solitary confinement cell looks like. Ammon Bundy just spent 13 hours in a cell this size, 3 foot by 3 foot, and it was totally concrete, and no bathroom, no water in there. He was handcuffed behind his back. He was shackled at the feet and could not lay down. They took him off of his bed at about 10 o'clock, 11 o'clock at night, we're being told, and he was taken into a solitary confinement cell this size and left for 13 hours. And so we're trying to bring awareness to this out here in Pahrump, Nevada, at the Nevada Southern Detention Center. It's a CCA corporation, that's ran privately. It's all private grounds here. This is not a state prison or a federal prison. It's a privately owned building and prison. It's a corporation, and they contract out to house people, to hold humans here, and they treat them horribly at this place, chaining up some people for up to 4 days to a bench without using the restroom, laying in their own feces and urine, and not even able to be laid down. They was actually chained to a bench. And other reports, like Ammon Bundy, was able to tell us it's being investigated as we're speaking. He was put in a jail cell this size for 13 hours. His clothes ripped off of him. He was beat up. And his supposed crime was inside the jail. He had a shirt that was hanging from his bunk bed. So think about this. He didn't stab nobody. He didn't rape nobody. He didn't steal nobody else's food. He didn't even yell at nobody. He didn't argue with nobody. He had a shirt, just like this man here's wearing, Robert, a jail scrub, hanging from his bunk. And they
was it trying to block the light, maybe?
Possibly trying to block the light, because the lights are on 24 hours a day here. So he just hung it up off the side of his bunk. And took him off to a solitary confinement cell and locked him up for 13 hours. He is currently still in solitary confinement. And the cell that he's in right now, I'm told, is about 6 foot wide by 8 foot long. So this jail cell is about the size of your king size or queen size bed. And think about being confined to that size of approximately that size for day after day after day. And seldom ever get out of it. Maybe an hour a day, I'm told here, possibly to take a shower or make phone calls. And even his phone calls are restricted. So we've got a report here just right now that I was just told that a guard that mistreated and targeted Ammon Bundy was sent home and has not returned yet. So he must be on some type of paid leave or unpaid leave. We don't know. But that is the report we've got right now, that this guard has been sent home. We know that by other reports that some people from the CCA Corporation over these federal prisons came all the way from Tennessee and showed up here today. And we don't know the outcome of this, but they're investigating this prison supposedly as we're speaking. And they've been here today, and we don't know if this is going to continue for several days. So we're bringing some attention to this prison. We don't want any more abuse. We want these guys to be treated humanely if they're going to detain them the way they're detaining them. These guys have not even been, they haven't even been tried yet. And they haven't been convicted. They've just been charged. And they're trying to work these guys at 20 cents an hour. That's slave labor. You don't work anybody for 20 cents an hour. If I can see possibly, if you just want to go past all this, if somebody was convicted of a crime and they've been sent to prison, and that's the way it is, and that's the way our system is set up, if they've been convicted and they are a convicted criminal, if they're sitting in prison, giving them a job and possibly paying them 20 cents an hour. But someone who has never, ever been convicted, think about this, people, has never been convicted of a crime yet. They're just waiting on trial. And then they are getting paid 20 cents an hour to work in this prison. I don't see how anybody can justify that. It's totally wrong. I can possibly do that. We wanted to play a video of Ammon's conversation, at least part of it here. That how Ammon was talking when he was in solitary confinement, for whoever wants to get on there. If people want to share this to people, we'll try to play this video over the speakers here while Robert's here in this solitary confinement cell doing his time. And we're trying to raise awareness here, for one, how the prisons are treating people. And then number two, we're trying to raise some funds for attorneys to help these guys and help the Ammon Bundy's defense team. And we're going to try to play Ammon Bundy's video here
and see if we can let you hear this first, or maybe even watch it here in a moment. I know a lot of you might have watched this already, but it's I think about 15 minutes long, but it's very sad and disturbing how Ammon Bundy was treated here, and even the others. We don't want to make light of this at all. This is a very serious situation out here, and that's why we're here from all over the country. All of us have better things we could be doing with our time than out here standing up for our neighbor and our brother, which is very important, and that's why we're here doing that. We're not wanting to begrudge that at all, because we're definitely happy to be here, but it's under terrible circumstances why we have to be here.
What date was that? Was it yesterday? I wasn't here.
You may have my number.
Oh.
So we might have found it here.
You want to put on the loudspeaker?
I'll just put it right next to his phone.
So we'll try to play this here for you.
Hey guys, we're going live here. We've got Ammon Bundy on the phone.
Tell us if you can see this here.
He's live from solitary confinement after being beat up and traumatized all night. And this is at the CCA for-profit prison in Pahrump, Nevada. And so I'm going to turn it over to Ammon. If you guys can hear him, please let me know. It's a little bit of a difficult situation here, but we're going to do the best that we can. Ammon, go ahead and say hi.
So, anyway, I just wanted everybody to, I don't know, maybe understand a little bit the situation.
Ammon, tell us what you...
This call is from an inmate facility.
The main thing I want is to believe my wife. I don't want people calling her a liar.
We believe her, Ammon. Tell us what you have been through. She said that there were moments that you actually had circulation being cut off and you thought that they were going to kill you.
Well...
What happened?
They didn't like that I had a shirt hung over my bunk bed, I guess. So the guy took it and... That's fine and dandy, but the problem is if you don't have your shirt, they won't, then you can't get breakfast the next morning because they won't let you eat unless you have a shirt. And my other two shirts were in the laundry, so anyway, I tried to get it back and he refused. Then Ryan got involved and he tried to get it back. And anyway, then they decided to use force on us. And, drug right out in the hallway. Actually, they said that they wanted to talk right out in the hallway, and so he went out there willingly and talked to him, and I told him that I wanted to keep an eye on him because I was afraid of what they might do to him, and they said all they wanted to do is talk to him. That's all they said. Anyway, he talked out there for a while, and the next thing you know, they're following him down the hallway. And then they came in, and I demanded to know what they were going to do with Ryan, and they wouldn't tell me, and the other people in the pod were upset because they saw how the guy lied and told him that we insulted him, the guard, you know, and they were upset, so the pod was upset. They wanted me to get out of into the hallway so they could do what they wanted to do with me without worrying about the other inmates, and so they grabbed me and drug me out, beat me to the ground, and beat me, you know, and hit me and shoved their fingers in my ears and behind my ears. Anyway.
Can you tell us
handcuffed
the name?
Me and,
can you tell us the names of any of the guards who were assaulting you?
No, and I don't want to quite go there yet, Kelly. I know maybe I should, but I don't want to be like them. I don't want to retaliate.
I know. That's fine. I'm just asking.
They need accountability, but I don't know. Maybe I have more faith in people same old song. The problem is the tyrants.
They are.
They don't recognize themselves. Just justify it all. I mean, I don't even get it. I can't think that way. And
okay, so they,
I don't get it.
They took you, then they took you into a shower stall?
They drug me down, yeah. And they took me down into...
This call is from an inmate facility.
Threw me in a shower. It's about a... It is a... probably about a 3x3... block.
Yeah.
Brick shower. It has a metal door on the back side of it. And I'm handcuffed and... They did take my leg irons off, but my leg irons had cut around my ankle and both my legs, so they were bleeding.
Your ankles were bleeding.
And both of them, because of the trip down the long hallway with the leg irons on. And then I'm handcuffed behind my back. I got my arms turned out, you know, so that really bad position. And with that little room, I could just crunch up, and I could never get any comfortable. I could stand up, but after a couple hours of that, I'd have to go back. Then I was hurting my shoulders.
Yeah.
And you were handcuffed this whole time?
Yeah, behind my back, and they were tight, and my hands were starting to swell up, cutting circulation off my hands, having to move my hands to keep circulation in my hands, and
my right shoulder,
I was in there for 13 hours, and they were telling me that I was going to be in there for 72 hours. But I think the reason why they abandoned that was because Ryan was calling. He could see a little bit of the shower from his cell. So he was calling and trying to, I think that's what brought a lot of tension. And
this call is from an inmate facility.
Mentioned one time that Nye County was going to come and investigate. And I think that's what, I don't know who said that, but whoever said that was wise in saying that, because they began to act different once that was said.
They didn't actually come and investigate?
I've never seen them or talked to them. No, I still would like to. I'd like to tell them what's going on.
You
I'd like to show them my hands and stuff.
You want to speak to the sheriff?
Either that or the commissioners.
Okay.
They have a responsibility to protect the people's rights in this county.
Yeah, they do.
Just because this facility has a federal contract, it doesn't negate their responsibility to protect the people that are within the boundaries of their county.
No, the contract does not give them.
What's happening here?
The contract does not give them the right to abuse anybody. No contract gives somebody the right to treat people the way that they are treating you and many other prisoners. What you're experiencing, you are bringing light to what many other people across this country are going through, Ammon. And I commend you for being bold enough to share your story so that people can get involved and people can tell their neighbors what's going on and how we need to get to the jails and set these people free, all of them. If you guys are not going to receive due process, then there's no reason for you to be sitting in these jail cells just to be tortured and abused. This isn't America. This isn't how we do things.
No. Well, what they wanted from me is they wanted nothing but for me to submit. They wanted my spirit. They wanted to tear. That's all they want.
Yeah.
And so I spent, because they're like, well, we'll take your handcuffs off if you'll just strip and.
This call is from an inmate facility.
And do what we tell you to. And that's all they want, Kelly. And it's no different than, I don't know, but it seems no different to me than any other torture. I mean, think about torture chambers, they drag you in and they throw you in there and then they inflict physical pain on you to get you to, you know, do what they want you to do or admit to something that they want you to admit or deny something that they want you to deny, but it's all through force, and that's what I just experienced. And
you're absolutely a prisoner of war, Ammon. There's no other way around it. You are a prisoner of war.
Well, it got pretty, I don't know, I was quite a bit of pain, you know, in there, and I couldn't sleep, because I'd been up, you know, the day, and then all through the night, about 30 hours, almost 30 hours, I think, yeah, it's probably right around 30 hours since I had been able to, you know, so I was in there without sleep, and then I had to go to the bathroom, and there's no place, so I just put that in the drain, but then I, you know, that was difficult.
Right there in the 3-foot by 3-foot shower that they left you in for 13 hours is where you also had used the bathroom.
Well, yeah, there's no other choice. I mean, I had to go to the bathroom twice, and then I didn't want to use, there's no water. Of course, they don't feed you, but there's a shower there. But the problem is if I turn the shower on, it's too small, I would have got wet, and I was already, the temperature's already at the point, and probably because of, you know, the shock of my body and stuff, I was already shivering, shaking. I didn't want to get wet because I felt that I would be really cold then. And anyway, so then they kept telling me that if I don't submit, that they're going to escalate the force on me. And I just kept telling them, look, they don't have a right to do what they're doing. They can't, you know, they don't have a right to torture me just because they are not willing to give them what they want. And so anyway, then, so probably around close to noon or something today, I think, they came in with like a SWAT team. They're fully geared up. Like riot gear. I've never seen it here before like that. And they, you know, they opened the door and drug me out. And at that point, I could, you know, I was still in my handcuffs, and it was hard to get up and walk. But they weren't too mean to me.
The thing is,
we have to understand that in their eyes, this is all my fault. And you know, I mean, I don't know.
It's not your fault, Ammon.
I could be a good. I'm just not a good prisoner.
You're not a good slave. You're not a good slave.
I know, but.
That's all. This isn't your fault.
If I would just comply and accept, I could probably be a lot easier in here, but I don't know.
If you comply and accept, then that's what we are.
You have 1 minute remaining.
Then that's what we are to do out here as well. Ammon, there's a group of us that'll get together and we'll fly down to Nevada and we'll be there by this weekend and we'll bring as many elected officials as we can and we will make sure that you have a meeting with either commissioners or the sheriff. So you can mark my words.
I'm telling you.
We will come, okay? We'll come. John will come.
I really believe not for my sake, but for the sake of what might happen to somebody else. They intended to leave me in there for 72 hours and it would almost have killed me. I'm certain of it. 13 hours was enough.
Well, you have 500 listeners right now. Do you think they'll let you call back in?
Your time is up.
So that was Ammon Bundy from CCA, Pahrump, Nevada Detention Center, Hostage Center. Where he had a shirt hanging off of the edge of his bed last night, so they drug him out at 10 p.m. and threw him in a 3-foot by 3-foot room shower for 13 hours with no food and water. And after that, he was stripped naked and thrown into solitary confinement with no clothes. And it was one guard who came and brought him back his garments. America, wake up!
So yeah, that was a pre-recorded call from Ammon, and so we just played it back for you. That is not a current call. I saw a couple people post that. John is over behind us talking to one of the correctional officers that been making trips checking on us. You know, Robert's still over here. He's still hanging in. I will let John know about the comments from Matt.
Well, I know who I believe.
I know who I believe, too.
So, as you can see, John Lamb's over there. This is Skipper talking, by the way.
We're just hoping to have some food. It's not the best. There's something else going on, believe me. That's you don't have food.
Trying to educate the correctional officer, it sounds like.
Hey, Rocky, I'm not able to hear anything. I was hearing Ammon's, it's okay, Kirby. I'm just wondering what his point of view is.
He's saying that
he works here.
I don't know how many prisons you've worked in, but that's not what happens here. We don't abuse these guys. It sounds like it's being blown out of proportion.
So Ammon wasn't locked in a thing for 13 hours is what he's saying. He's saying Ammon's lying.
He's saying we don't do that here. This doesn't happen here.
Ammon's not in there?
So I said I've worked 5 prisons from a level 5 all the way down for the last 20 years as an officer and a sergeant. And so I'm very aware, and he just talked over the top of me, and I said, hold on a minute.
Nice to hear things get louder.
So he wasn't listening. He was just, you know, he saw something on Facebook that they're all beat up and bloody and everything like that. And so he was trying to say that it wasn't true.
What's his rank?
And I said,
what's his rank?
He's just an officer. He's just doing outside patrol and stuff like that. Like that, so he's just an officer.
He's not a.
And he works for a private prison, so they have no training. They've got no formal schooling that they actually go to. So, you know, in the California, you know, I did 16 weeks, you know, so I didn't do 16 weeks, I did 5 weeks, and then it went up to 16 weeks. So,
But he's denying.
He's denying it.
Yeah.
Okay. He's absolutely denying. That's why I walked away.
Was he told to come out here, or did he just come out?
I seriously doubt he was told to come out here. I think that in are you recording me?
Yes.
I don't want to put that what I was going to say on, but I believe that he's. Well, if you're recording this, I'm going to choose my words carefully. He's denying it. Mm-hmm. And the reason that he could very well be denying it is that we just got word that the guard that was involved in putting Ammon in handcuffs for 13 hours has been sent home.
Right.
And so
he did not know that
he's guilty of anything.
Right.
There's just...
So he could very well be a friend of the guy that was just sent home. And so he's coming to his rescue saying this isn't true and everything else. I'm sorry, but I did 20 years. And like I just told him, 99.5% of the time I'm going to call these guys liars. I know the Bundy family, and I know that they're very honorable people, and that Ammon's not going to lie. So me doing what I've done for the amount of time I've done, I'm here because I believe what he has to say is absolutely the truth. And I don't think that he's lying, but I think the guy that just came out here is just trying to cover it up. That was my personal opinion. He didn't want to hear what I had to say.
Did you ask him how long he's worked here?
I don't even care. I don't even care.
Did he offer that up to you, John?
He's offering to talk to the warden, give her a message for us again, to try to see if we can talk to the warden.
Why can't he just let us tell the warden to come out here and we can talk?
He's probably got no access to her, so he can make promises.
He pretty much told me that... He pretty much said that he's not even really supposed to be talking to us.
He's probably not supposed to be talking to us. I guarantee he's not supposed to stop and actually talk to us.
Well, he just did.
Yeah, and I see that as an uneducated way of covering it up, because I'd be willing to bet that he is friends with the guy that got sent home today. So he's probably sticking up for him. And if I wasn't being recorded... I'm still being recorded, so I'm not going to say anything. Sorry, guys, I'm not going to give my total opinion on that. But I'll say other things when I'm not on camera. Yeah, I'm not going to put myself out there like that. But I'd be willing to bet that he's friends with the guy that got sent home today.
All right.
So, and I'll tell you more when we're not being recorded as well.
All right.
Yeah, I'll give you my 100% unfiltered opinion on that.
We're going to get a light here, guys, so we can kind of lighten things up, hopefully. Robert's got like 35 minutes to make 2 hours.
I didn't think I'd make an hour, so that's pretty cool.
How's it going, Bob? How you feeling?
Sucks, huh?
Yeah.
Really bad. Like, it's hardest on the shoulders.
Yep. Those joints.
And you can hook your fingers in my pants to relieve the pain on the wrist.
But then it hurts your shoulders worse.
The shoulders worse. So there's really no possible way I can imagine going 13 hours. And when he mentioned they threatened 72 hours, I could see that that would, you know, I don't know how it would kill you, but it would definitely... Well, I guess you would die from pain because your shoulders would be dislocated and you would just, you couldn't,
pass out from the pain at least.
Yeah, or something. There's no way to kill yourself.
You could actually beat your head against the wall until you are unconscious.
Yeah.
And if you know how to manipulate the cuffs, you can actually cut your wrists.
Well,
but
I think I would probably,
a little rough.
I would probably cry eventually.
Can I borrow your lighter
again? Yes, ma'am.
I changed pants. I actually put some clean ones on.
Oh, yeah.
Actually, if you let me borrow a cigarette,
mm-hmm.
I'm not going to borrow it because I'm not going to give it back.
You're not going to give it back. These are actually... come from the Indian reservation and there's no chemicals in them, so you're not getting any rat poison like
you used to.
They're all poison.
Oh. God.
What did you think of that conversation?
BS.
This right here, brother? This right here? Here. I'm going to step away from the camera. Don't put anything else. I just started with the guy that just got
the light's still not bright enough in there, so.
Did you hear when I started to talk? You just talked over the top of it. You didn't want to hear what I had to say. No, I got 20 years. He may not have listened to it. But if you walk
said, you know, this is the I'm sorry, coach. You know, if you have any faith in the system, good luck.
I guarantee he's friends with the guy that got sent home. I'm one of the best. I've seen it a million times, partner. I've seen it a million times. That good old boy kind of poke up, you know, kind of protect my friend, you know.
Viewers. Oh, you got a real lantern over there. What's up?
Yeah, I was sitting there thinking about that. And tell them about how much
it does my left shoulder hurt so much? I don't even feel my right shoulder hurt, but my left one's killing me.
See, mine was the opposite. Mine was the right shoulder more than my left. And my shoulder...
Boy, does it make your neck sore.
So you've been in there, almost an hour and a half?
About, yep.
So I've been out for almost 2 hours. I've been out for 2 hours, and I'm still sore.
Now, for people that are just joining us that are asking questions here, we've been having a demonstration today out here in Pahrump, Nevada. It's in front of a prison out here. It's the Nevada Southern Detention Center. And we're trying to bring awareness to the abuse that's going on in this this prison. And we've got a jail cell here that we're trying to light up and let you see kind of what it looks like that we made this morning. It's 3 foot by 3 foot. And the gentleman that's in here, his name is Robert. He was our second volunteer for the day. He's from Oregon. And he's handcuffed behind his back with real handcuffs. And
with my wrists out.
With his wrist out, just like they handcuffed a guy that's inside of this jail. And he's been in there for right about an hour and a half now. And we are trying to bring awareness here and show people what it's like. And experience is the best way to do this.
Cody, stay here.
We are right in front of the prison entrance, and the prison sets about a half a mile back off of this road here. We're right along the highway here. So the traffic that comes in and out of this prison gets to see the demonstration we're doing. We've been camping out here day and night, 24 hours a day we've been camping here. His dog's name is Cody. But we've got tents set up out here. We've got campers. We've got a makeshift kitchen out of a tent. And and Robert has been complaining for just a little while about how bad his shoulder hurts just from being handcuffed an hour and a half. The last gentleman was in there for 4 hours, and he barely made it. We probably won't go all night tonight, but we're thinking about possibly doing this one night this week. And because Ammon went in at about 10 o'clock at night, and he was in there for 13 hours all night long without sleep, water, or food, and didn't have a restroom. It is cooler out here right now. That's one thing we're thankful for, that it's cooler. And maybe is a little bit easier, but we've been at this all day today, from marching around this prison showing the prisoners that we're here. We got up early. We've got a lot of things we're doing around here. It's been nonstop all day, so I'm sure Robert is getting somewhat tired. It's been a long day. Even if he's only been in there an hour and a half, it's a long time. Thank you, Naomi, for bringing some awareness here. Some of these guys have not been out of here for 16 months. There's others that we're not even familiar with that we're being told was even held here 3 and 4 years without even going to trial. They haven't even been found guilty yet of a crime. That's right, David Zionberger. We're waiting for you to get back out here from Las Vegas. We're hoping you'll do the challenge too.
Oh, I'm paying. Hoping. Looking forward to it.
We've got some people challenging David Zionberger to this torture chamber challenge. Thanks, Lori. Debbie says, hang in there, buddy. Your doggie's right here.
Who?
Your dog is right here. Debbie?
Yeah.
Says, hang in there, buddy. Debbie Gibson.
Thanks, Debbie.
Robert says, thanks, Debbie. I know the light's not very good out here, but we're doing the best we can with what we have set up out here. So, Branstead, you're a rock star. He says you rock.
Rolling stones gather no moss. Whatever that means.
We would put Bran Thornton in there, but he wouldn't be able to blow the shofar, so...
Well, we can all practice then. We can take practice on this.
I've tried that so far, man. That's a lot harder than it looks.
I almost got a toot out of it once, but it's pretty hard.
Help me. Somebody out there, just help. Help us in here. Guys are just in there constantly, just wondering if anyone cares or anybody's going to help. We're trying to help, and I don't know what we all can do, but pretending that it's not all that bad is not an option.
David Zionberger says his shoulders are already shot from many years of learning about the law. An educating growth industry.
Well, he can show us what he knows then while he's in here. Because he will be in here. I can assure you. I'm going to try. I may not be able to get up, but I'm going to try. Oh, no. Oh, can't do that. This is as good as it gets, and it ain't no better than anything else. Make sure my dog has a kiss.
Cody.
This is laying down in 3x3 stall.
Hey, Kristen. See what we built out here? We got a 3x3 jail cell out here. We did, we were told today that the guard that mistreated Ammon Bundy, that did him this way for 13 hours, has been sent home. We don't know if that's sent home with pay or without pay, but we know that he has been sent home. We also know little bits and pieces that the warden here, the last warden, has also is no longer working here. And we don't know if that's administrative leave also or how, but we know that there is a new warden in this prison for just about 1 week or less. One of the other things we know is that that some investigators came from Tennessee today and are investigating this prison. So there was CCA, their investigators that supposedly work for this, for the CCA corporation out of Tennessee, but they came here from Tennessee just to investigate. Another thing that might be of interest, and we don't know how far it's going, is but the sheriff of this county told us that we would not hear from her if she started an investigation here, a criminal investigation. She has not called us. She hasn't answered our phone calls. So possibly that's the reason we haven't heard back from the sheriff. But I was there personally when she said that she, you will not hear from me if I start an investigation here. And so there's a lot of things behind the scenes playing here that we don't know about. And we can update you only as we know what's going on here. But you know that investigators came from Tennessee. They're investigating the prison here. And we know that the guard that abused and mistreated Ammon Bundy has been sent home. We don't know if that's with pay or without pay. And we do know that the guard here is, or the warden here, is last warden is no longer working here for some reason, and they have hired a new warden. So there's a lot of interesting things happening here. I think what we're doing here is getting something done, is bringing attention to some problems here. So I think it's working. We need more people. We have a county commissioner, Donna Cox, that's supposed to be coming out here too. She might have came out here today to the prison, maybe with the investigators, but we know that she's actively involved investigating this too. We have information of that. She might even stop by here and walk out here. So that's Donna Cox of this Nye County. We still got Robert in here. He's been in here for quite a while now. And it's completely dark out here in Pahrump, Nevada. The temperature has dropped. It's getting a little cooler. David says, leave you in the fall out of the
Well, he better start praying.
Sarah Stein. Good evening, Sarah Stein.
Okay, I need a man.
Alternative media, we don't know where they're at. You need some help?
I'm going to ask someone to lean against this side because I'm going to get up, and I'm afraid if I do, this thing's going to fall over.
Okay, we'll hold this other side. Okay, we're
ready. Go ahead, partner.
I'm pretty sure that would have tipped it over. Oh God.
We have this box tied down, but
not that
well. We've from the wind and stuff.
I'm a little heavy these days.
Yeah, we need help calling media. We need them out here to spread this worldwide. People need to know what's happening in this jail.
Not just this one.
All over. This should not happen anywhere in the United States. Thanks, Twyla. Yeah, the prisoners don't have bail here. They are holding these people here without bail.
For Bob?
Well, it's getting close to the 2-hour mark for Bob.
Wow.
Bob, do you have a number so you can get out of here by 2 hours? Or you want to try to make it 3 hours?
17 minutes for the 2-hour mark.
All right. I'm not sure what I want. Oh.
I think we ought to get
If we could get him out of there for $200, I don't know if we can try to do that.
Should I text that?
Yes.
I really don't want to get him out before I'm almost dead, but I want to make sure that I'm doing my part to help support the legal defense fund, and it's the knowing that people have been in here for many, many hours by themselves without anyone even knowing it, and here I am surrounded with people.
Teresa, maybe we'll make sure he doesn't hurt himself, but we're trying to raise awareness here to what this prison's doing, and we're also trying to bring in some funds for some of the prisoners here and their defense team, and it goes directly to the lawyers. It does not go into anyone's pocket here. It goes directly to the lawyers. You can actually check out that website and see it. James Madison promised $10 an hour. I'll give a total of $50, he says, if he gets out now. So that's just a few minutes away at the 2-hour mark. I will donate $10. The goal of the bail is $500. Skipper won't probably go in tomorrow, will you, Skipper?
I don't know if I'll be back tomorrow.
It may not be tomorrow, it might be the next day. But we've got a lot of volunteers the next several days. Right now, this is going to go on for a few more days, so we've got enough volunteers to fill up the next couple of days. And more volunteers, it sounds like they're coming.
Okay, we are at the 15 minute mark.
15 minutes to go for 2 hours, so. Kimberly says she'll be back in a few. Thanks, Kimberly.
Okay, 15 minutes. Bob will be in there for 2 hours. He's hurting pretty bad. So let's raise some bail money for him.
There's Nancy Henderson says she will donate $250.
Whoa.
Oh, Nancy, you are.
$250 from Nancy.
Thank you, Nancy.
Thank you, Nancy.
We're trying to raise money for Bob over here.
The money is going to the Bundy defense team. That's Morgan Philpott. It goes directly to him. Nancy here, Whitfield, says she's donating $50.
She's a gem.
Thank you, Nancy.
Thank you, Nancy.
So that was $300 just from two people.
They're great. You know.
Every little bit helps.
Yeah, it adds up.
Shave your beard.
This is a heck of a lot more important than most things.
Dude, the beard's not being shaved. End of discussion.
That's a separate deal.
Back for bail.
They can see
Thomas,
my hair.
You
could
donate at
www.bundy.com.
Defense.com.
Kelly, it's still Robert in there. He's almost in there for 2 hours. We got to add James' money on here of $50 too, so we know there's at least $350, if not more. So we've had other people I know in the beginning here give $5 and $10, $20. We know it's several hundred dollars here. And it's already dark out here. Yeah, we need to add up the donations. We will have those totals, hopefully, on each one of these people later today. Because some people aren't even mentioning that they're donating here, and we will have those totals later. Sonia Black here says $20. Thank you, Sonia.
Thank you, Sonia.
We got 12 minutes.
So we got 12 minutes left to keep. Kelly Stewart says she's putting in $10 an hour. Bob.
Thank you, Kelly.
Somebody says it's over $400 now.
Robert Hoffman, John Lamb is on the list. Dave Fleeman's on the list. DJ Soper's on the list. Amy Patterson's on the list.
Ruth said
Kelly
$50.
Stewart's on the
Thank
list.
You, Ruth. Thank
Sarah
you, Laura
Redhawk's
Jones.
On the list.
Sean said just said $50. Thanks, Sean.
Friday, I think is what she said. Well, 100 people had to donate. She didn't give an amount. She just said 100 people.
Thanks, Matt. We appreciate that.
Donna Hammond, yes, that is Robert sitting there handcuffed in the box right now. And his palms are out, so it's a painful position.
Thank you, Eddie, there. Sean sent $50. We've got...
Thank you, Sean.
Someone else has said it'd be a day or so, but they're sending $10. Nancy Gardner says she's donating $20.
Thank you, guys.
Thanks, Nancy. And I know there's a lot of other names. This is probably donating. I appreciate you. And if we're missing someone's name, we don't mean to miss your name. There's a lot of messages coming on here.
Talk like an auctioneer, please.
Talk like an auctioneer.
$1 going once, going twice. I don't know how to auction off.
Can I get another dollar? Can I get another dollar? Everybody send a dollar.
We don't have
We're
no
raising
professional.
Bail money for Bob over here. He's hurting people. Donna Hammond's putting in $20.
Thanks, Donna Hammond. That's awesome. You know Donna Hammond, don't you?
I know Donna Hammond and her husband Steve.
Desiree,
she gets some money
$10. Thank you, Desiree.
Steve also,
Donna,
yes.
Are you getting money from your husband also?
Can I get a dollar? Can I get a dollar? Because can anybody give a dollar? I'd like
I
to hear $2,
what
$2,
are $2,
$2.
If I say
$2.
I'm going to go another half hour, are we going to get some?
Callie,
$20.
Easton says $20.
Huh?
Callie gave $20. Thank you, Callie.
Thank you, Callie.
Thank you, Callie.
We just got a few minutes left here.
How many?
We got.
We can get Treason Bob out.
We got 11 minutes.
Let's bail Bob out. If everybody on here can get $1, $2. If we can get $2, anybody just put in $2. www.bundydefense.com. Dollar. I need a dollar. Come on, everybody send a dollar. $1. Just send $1, $2. Can you give me $2? I'd like to get $2.
I got 5,000 people on my Facebook. If everybody gave
$1.
$1. That's $5,000.
I'm not asking
They're
you for 10.
They're saving their money for some bigger names. They're saving their money for you, Skipper. John,
I don't know, man. I think people are going to leave me to
John's
rot in there.
John's going to get some major, major
My buddy,
interest.
Thomas Applegate, I've known him for many years since
I
he was a teenager.
I don't want to beg anybody.
He just donated $20.
Thank you for the $20.
My good buddy from many years ago.
Thanks, Diana.
Actually, I'm finding an equilibrium here.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Karen Fraser says she's given $50.
Wow, Karen.
Love you, brother.
Kristen Thomas says she will on Friday. Kristen has given so much already.
Yeah.
Paul, I can't pronounce your last. Rawl. Rawl says $100. Rawl's given $100.
Paul Rawl, you just gave
$100. 9 minutes left.
Nine minutes left.
Thank you.
Can
Michael King Barker, $100. Or Michelle. Michelle.
$100.
I'm seeing things out here in the dark, and it's hard to read everything, and I am tired. But thank you, Michelle.
Thank you, Michelle. Thank you and so Raul. Much. If we can bail him out, everybody on here give a dollar.
Dale Sills adding another $20, which he gave already $50. So thank you, Dale. You guys are awesome, you and your wife. You guys do so much over there in Oregon for everyone.
His shoulders are probably hurting.
Dale and Sarah Seals, you guys are awesome.
And the reason why we're doing this is because the torture that's been going on with their guys inside of prison. And we're, you know, raising money for
anybody. What handcuffs can do to you.
Callie's husband said $20.
Thank you.
It brings it up a little more to $100.
Do we have an address for prepaid Visa cards?
Oh.
I don't know how that works, but I'm sure.
We will get an address. Send me a PM tomorrow for a reminder.
Can they?
And we will work on that for you.
Can they send it straight to the Bundys? Don't they have a PO box there in Bunkerville?
Yeah. No,
John Hancock says.
But they can also. They
he
can
needs an address too. We'll get you an address to mail it somewhere.
Yeah, Carol can.
Okay. We'll try to post it on here somehow. We'll have administrators go on here and look on the page and
get you,
try to find some addresses to add to people. Send us a private message, Jocel. It may be just to get overwhelmed with all the messages, but send us a private message, and we will get you the addresses and stuff. We appreciate it if you have to send it instead.
And I believe it's the P.O. Box in Bunkerville, Nevada, and make it out to the Bundy family. And Bunkerville is so small that the people at the post office are going to know exactly what post office to put it in. Address it to Carol Bundy. She'll make sure that it input it is the defense fund, and Carol is going to make sure that it goes to the defense fund.
Well, nominate
I know,
her for that.
But you know she will. Carol, I love you if you're watching this. I absolutely just think you are the most wonderful lady
in
the world.
On that, Natalie, you just have to go to the website and punch in the numbers from the prepaid card and see if it works.
Oh, that's true.
You can still see that. Robert's in there. He's linked over right now. It's hard to see him, but
I'll put the light in.
Thank you for posting that address on there.
7 minutes.
There we go.
To raise some bell money to get out of this box.
And you can see
get the handcuffs off of him. Kim Thomas, we decided like at certain points when as a group we decided that's other being. The individual is probably having a hard time, or even the person agrees with it. The first person was at 4 hours right now, and so we're using the bell as a boost to raise money real fast right before the time's up. So that's why we're doing a so-called bailing a person out.
But I also want to say that he's a little bit older than the first guy that came in, so it is very hard on him. I'm gonna stick up for you here, partner. It's very hard on his shoulders. It's very hard on his body, on his back, on his knees, on his wrist. And if you guys don't know who I am, I'm Rocky Hall. I did 20 years in prison, so I might have a little bit of a clue.
Serving or working?
A lot of difference sometimes. I worked in prison for 20 years as an officer and as a sergeant.
Good job, fellas.
Yeah, for people that don't know here again, we're out here in front of Pahrump, Nevada. It's a detention center ran by CCA. Ruth says, mine confirmed, $50 to PayPal.
Awesome.
Thank you, Ruth.
Thank you, Ruth.
So, yeah, we're out here in front of Pahrump, Nevada. Detention center, and we've got a jail cell that's pretty small. It's 3 foot by 3 foot. It's kind of a replica of what's inside the prison, and one of the guys spent 13 hours inside the cell inside this prison with his hands cuffed behind his back. And
5 minutes.
Five more minutes left to get Robert out of jail here.
Can everybody give a dollar? Just $1. Everybody that's listening, looking.
Cindy, my time is coming.
$1. If everybody on here right now can give $1 to the Legal Defense Fund, we can do it. Let's get this guy out. Bail him out. Bail him out. All the money raised is going into the Bundy Legal Defense Fund. This is a fundraiser, and this guy is torturing himself right now to raise
Sharon
money.
Joyce just, she said she put $50 earlier tonight. Thanks, Sharon.
Thanks, Sharon.
Thank you, Sharon.
It's awesome.
Thank you so much.
We're trying to bring awareness here to this prison, on the torture chambers they have in this. Is Callie just put $1 more? Thank you.
Thank you.
And
$1,
Catherine
$1,
said $20.
$1. Everybody
Catherine,
online right now.
Thank you,
give
Catherine,
$1.
For $20. And thank you. Who was the other one?
Yes.
Catherine.
The first one. Who before that?
Hang on, partner.
I want to keep going.
Callie.
Thank you, Callie.
Callie and Catherine. Thank you.
No one's lost the key.
There might be missing
right?
somebody here.
Remember, this is to raise money drain. For the Ammon Bundy.
$3. Thanks.
So that's going to be public, but I'm just putting it out there so other people can hear it as well.
We're just about to get Robert out of here.
How many minutes, Skip?
Three more minutes.
Jake gets to bring awareness to what the prison's doing here. We have changed a lot in the last couple of days. They had this prison on lockdown. They had a prisoner in solitary confinement. One prisoner spent 13 hours inside of a solitary confinement cell. Just he's no longer in that solitary confinement cell, but 13 hours handcuffed with his legs bleeding and his arms bleeding after he'd been abused and beat.
What I'll have you do is just hold the light when I take the handcuffs off.
No,
so we just got
he's setting up a countdown for 2 minutes.
Okay.
We just got about 2 minutes left here, and we're going to get Robert out of here. We're going to continue this for the next several days. Penny said she sent another $20. Thanks, Penny.
Thank you, Penny.
Okay, we got the 2 minute countdown.
2 minute countdown.
David Fleeman's phone set up.
Woo-hoo. So. And your ear is waiting for Dad to get out of prison.
You can see it too.
So if you guys could donate a dollar to the dog, what's your dog?
Thank you, Nancy, for what you've done there. That's awesome. Nancy has spent $250 already on the Bundy defense team.
Thank
here earlier,
you
but thank
so
you, Penny.
Much.
That's awesome. Every little bit's helping. We've got someone else here that just sent $10.
Yeah, that's a lot of things.
Okay, he loves me.
So we're down to 1 minute and 18 seconds, and we're fixing to get out of here.
Can you set the light while I grab the key?
They got
the,
sure. Get the...
You grab this, and
got
what
it.
I'm gonna do is I'm gonna hold it.
Yeah, 1 minute. 1 minute.
We're ticking it down here. We're fixing to get Robert out of here and unhandcuff him. Don says she's mailing $20. Thanks, Don.
And handcuffs, keys ready.
I got the handcuff keys ready.
There they are. It's a little bit of, that's what freedom looks like.
I'll
right
give
now.
Everybody another update after we get Robert out of handcuffs and just speak a few minutes before we go offline and kind of tell you what's going on. Sharon says she's sending $100. Thank you, Sharon.
Thank you, Sharon. That's a lot.
Indeed,
thank
thanks
you.
For posting that address again there on here for us.
No.
Thanks to all the help everybody's giving us here. It's awesome.
That's the
sometimes
team.
Behind the camera out here.
9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Happy New Year!
There we go.
Skip,
let's get him out of here.
Watch me do this. Bring Skipper, come on up here and watch me take the cuffs off. Bring your hands out. All I'm going to do is I'm going to bring you out this way. And I used to do this for a living, so I might know what I'm doing. So I do this. And then I got to get the key out. So no resisting. Stop resisting. Stop resisting.
We're going to have to beat you and lock you up again.
There you go.
That's right. Code
that was
word.
2 hours for Robert in there.
Thank you, right,
let's
buddy?
Put that light back if we can just for a few more minutes. There we go. We'll get him out of there. There
can
you go.
Can you tell us how your shoulders feel?
After 2 hours.
Yeah. Sore.
Skip, wait. You want to go ahead and bring your camera in here and let's take a look at his wrist. Now, he is a bigger guy.
Ow!
Whoa. I thought you've done this before.
Oh my God!
And I'm telling you guys, I barely turned him. So what it does?
Creases right there.
Yeah, what it does is it cuts off the circulation through here, and all these muscles have been pulled back in a wrong direction. And he's not a weak man.
No.
So he's got these muscles that have been turned and twisted in the wrong direction, and that's why they hurt. So let's go ahead and take a look at the other arm. And I'm
not
gonna
turn my shoulder, otherwise it would like I have to.
Nice red mark right there.
Yeah, and it's hands. You can see that they're a little swollen and everything like that. So you look at them, and you see what it.
Takes a little longer for the blood to go through.
I would seriously like to have a long conversation over beer with these people.
Well, we got you a bottle of water right now.
The camera, the blood is starting to, you know, you can see when I press down.
That's called capillary refill there.
There you go. Thank you. I knew there was a word. I knew that. But look what I'm doing. I'm pushing on it, and you can see that it's really hard for the blood to come back and flow through. And he's a little bit older. I'm not going to say your age, but this is what it does. And, you know, he's not out of shape. He's in a good shape, but that's what it does. And bring the light up. And I'm going to talk about the shoulders again. For the shoulders to be pushed back, all these muscles right here are going in the wrong direction. And so...
Don't stop.
So, does this feel good?
Yeah.
Yep, okay. So, all this right here is just not natural to be pulled back like this. Everything here is being pulled back. So, I want to say that Ammon, after 13 hours, was told to put his hands on top of his head, and he couldn't do it. And this is after, what, 2 hours?
This is two hours.
And you see, it's kind of a little bit of a struggle for him to do that. So after 13 hours, Ammon could not by himself bring his hands up over his head. And I'm gonna put that out there for you guys. And you know this. And all these, anytime a guy is in shape, these muscles right through here and everything else, everything has been pulled back out of proportion. That's my lecture for the day. Yeah.
Well, thanks a lot, Robert.
So I look forward to when you get out.
That's right. I'll be in there either tomorrow or the next day.
Right. Are we doing somebody tonight, or are we going to wait until tomorrow morning?
I'll go next.
Are you going in there tonight?
VJ,
we'll shine that light on BJ here. BJ's actually going in the night.
I'm gonna go in tonight.
And so we're gonna continue this tonight.
So if you wanna donate, you know, in regards for BJ going in, if you wanna see him struggle, you know, now's the chance. Don't run away.
So here's our jail cell. Set back up here and get this ready.
So.
All right, so I'm going to rough him up, guys. I'm going to place him against the wall. And what I'm going to do is, this would actually be a wall here.
You want me to frisk him?
I'm going to spread his legs. I'm going to bring him back. I'm going to grab his thumbs. I'm going to pull him up like this, and I'm going to throw the cuffs on him. And this is how fast we're going to do it. So this is generally how we do it. I've got his thumbs. I've got his hands inside like this so I have better control. I've got my knee placed inside of his knee right here, and I've got him off balance so that if he resists on me, I'm going to slam him into the wall. I'm not going to do that. I'm not going to do that because he's actually been nice to me today, so I'm not going to hurt him. And what we're doing is we're taking the handcuffs, and I'm going to make sure that I lock them. And what I do when I'm putting there is I'm going to take my little finger, and I'm going to make sure that they're not too tight. So I clip them down until it's like right here. Now, how does that feel to you? It's okay? So now, what?
He says you can tighten them up.
Tighten them up? Well, I'm going to actually be a little bit polite on it. So now we're going to take the key, and I've got total control of him as I still have my knee behind his knee right here in case he resists. I'm going to slam him. But I've got my hands right here, and I've also got my arm in his back. And what I do is I take the key, And this right here is the locking mechanism here, and that's why it didn't lock. But what we're going to do is we're going to double lock these. And this right here is a double lock. So I take the handcuff key, shove it in there, and it double locks. So that when he is in his cell, this is not going to tighten up. And because his hands are this way, he's also not as capable of coming up here and picking this lock. So I put him on upside down. I sure did, guys. And I gave BJ
a
hard time for that.
And I did. And actually, what you're supposed to do is put the lock this part here so he can't take his hands and pick this lock. And I put him on upside down. Yes, I did. So, yes, wow. I did. So go ahead and put yourself in the holding cell, young man.
Oh, we got another going in, huh?
Do we have the time?
Yeah, we got BJ going in.
Do we?
What time? What is it?
8:47.
8:47.
We actually handcuffed them 2 minutes ago, so 8:45.
Let's call it 8:45. So BJ Soper is going into the holding cell at this time, and he's going to be in there for 17 hours.
Yeah. See you in the morning, bro.
We're going to try to keep this going for a while, this live stream, and we may have to just go to bed, like they said, for a while. But we'll get some light day.
We'll have a watch rotation for you, so you don't feel like abandoned.
Not after you done 4 hours in that
I'm
side.
I'm going to log off from now, but you can follow John Lamb. He's going to run his for a little bit longer. So we will give you more updates as we go on. Remember, visit www.bundydefense.com.
To get some more lights set up so we can see better here. Just give us just a little bit, but
I don't want to blind BJ either.
Can't see.
So it's kind of it's humbly is what it is.
Yes. Take the mic here for the
bring this huge
camera here. Here just a minute. The wind is really picking up.
Have you ever been in handcuffs before besides that one time?
One time in my entire life.
Yeah.
One time for an unpaid traffic.
Just a minute. Let's make sure don't blow.
Love you too, sweetie. Give my kid a kiss before she goes to bed.
I had to take you in February 2016 and threw me in the back seat of a King Cab truck.
As long as he can, Dale.
Oh man, my shoulders were killing me. The grease weren't that bad.
Deborah, we did it. You just didn't see it.
It's hard to answer questions when you're that miserable.
Sorry, guys. It is a little windy out here.
Throw a mic over it now.
Hopefully, this is going to help. You have to let us know here. We just put a mic over it now. Kind of a wind sock. The wind has really picked up. BJ so far is our third volunteer for today. So we've had two other individuals in here for 6 hours. And we have pretty much 24 hours around the clock here. Camping out here, sleeping out here, right in front of the jail. This is the end of day number 4 out here.
Staying strong. And raising dollars. Loving it.
Right now you can see him really good.
That's actually perfect for face level.
Okay.
Because my live feed is just junk, so I'm just going to take a photo and post it.
So, I know it's late for some of you out there on the East Coast. You may not be able to stay, but we'll keep this live stream going as long as we can, and see how long we last out here.
Just keep in mind that we're on our third person towers, and Ammon had to do it for twice as long. They put him through this punishment for twice as long.
Yes, right.
And that's why we're doing this, is to raise that money.
Third,
not just him again, but to anybody again.
Well, what about the poor people that end up in there for 72 hours? If they were going to keep him there for 72, he else done it for 72?
Well, like the gentleman that was strapped to a bench for 4 days.
I don't know.
How awesome is that? You know, yeah. I mean, at least he's on a bench, but still.
Yeah.
Chained to a bench for 4 days, not humane at all.
I remember the guys were combative and suicide that some did 4 and 5 point restraints, but they were and the 4 point restraints is around the wrist and around the ankles, and then a 5 point restraint would be the wrist and the head, but they were constantly
you just
monitored.
Started there's no sitting.
I just want to see how to do it.
But they were constantly monitored.
It's not too bad.
Well, he's all
guys.
Yeah, but could you imagine wearing the ankle shackles? You might not be able to do that. I thought about it earlier, you know.
Hurt like hell. I just banged the hell out of my wrist.
I know. I
pinched the handcuffs into your
I banged my knee really good.
The handcuffs up.
Yeah. You don't want to piss.
Honestly, after a little while, we'll hit shoulders. Feeling the burn in the shoulders.
Yeah. The hand, I have the hand.
Like you're in pain no matter what. It's the shoulders or the wrist. You know what? That just made me decide that I'm not going back into one of those things. Well, unless they want to donate another 100 bucks. Raised thousands of dollars today, fellas. I don't know.
I think he lost.
It was over $500.
He had 15 bucks an hour on his regular time.
So we got over $2,000 so far.
Yep. Whoops. That's okay. I'll cut the other one. Yes. There. Whoops. We've got a makeshift wind block here, so hopefully everybody can hear us a little better there. We'll take it to itself. There we go. Hopefully you can hear that better there. Let us know that there's homemade wind blocks that we're trying to block out the wind. It got kind of windy here. Plywood 3x3 cell that we built at just and PVC pipes just to kind of make it look like a jail cell, but it's not in Bundy end. So we don't really know what else is keeping track of that on the other end, but hopefully we'll know here soon how much is actually coming in for each. Got there was over $500 there that we brought in for through Robert being in there, and I think it was over $1,500 that we brought in for Eric. So
and we had a couple more people that just messaged me recently that are throwing in.
Anybody that would
we'll
actually,
tally it up later.
And anybody that actually would pay to keep BJ in there. We start that as well.
And we have BJ Super and Nancy. That would be amazing if we could get $2 for every person that's walking. And I'm here. on Mew in front of the prison here at a CCA correctional facility where they house close to 1,100 inmates here that are majority American citizens. There's hundreds and hundreds of American citizens that have never even had trial yet. One gentleman's 93 old, and he's a retired doctor, and he's waiting trial here. And he's gone. Light red, I'm treating him like he's guilty already. And he's never been convicted of. They're even working these prisoners here for 20 cents an hour. That's all they pay them. I've been told that's the max pay. And all of our political prisoners are in there that have accepted that job. 20 cents an hour. Dale Seals says he's taking the challenge of the $3 and everybody would do it, so he's paying $3 an hour, BJ, right now for you.
Times them by everybody that has equal amounts, quite a bit of money. So, system that you got to have money and have justice and win your freedom. But that's what it's going to take. And I love the dedication that we all have to be able to raise that money. I know we all know that the Bundys and everybody, not just Ammon and not just Ron, but
wind blocks on your hand. We're trying. If somebody got some better goals, it'd be great. We got a wind up. Guys, some of the wind is blowing quite windy here now. Go to that minutes ago. Nancy Henderson says the wind, and we apologize for that. Live stream going as long as we can. We'll figure out some more.
See.